हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज़ वीडियो वील बी स्टार्टिंग विद केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स। सो वील बी स्टार्टिंग विद द वेरी फर्स्ट कैटेगरी, दैट इज़ लेबोरेटरी टेस्ट्स। बट बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग द रिएक्शंस, यू ऑल शुड नो समथिंग। सी दिस पॉइंट, एल्डिहाइड्स आर ईजिली ऑक्सीडाइज्ड टू करस्पॉन्डिंग कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। प्रिपेरिंग एसिड फ्रॉम एल्डिहाइड, दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन यू ऑल हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर। सो वॉट इज द पॉइंट, दैट योर एल्डिहाइड कैन बी ईजिली ऑक्सीडाइज टू करस्पॉन्डिंग कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। देयर फोर योर एल्डिहाइड्स दैट आर देयर, दे एक्ट एज अ रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट टूवर्ड्स माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स। सी एल्डिहाइड्स आर ईजिली ऑक्सीडाइज, सो एल्डिहाइड्स दे एक्ट एज रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स, ओके, फॉर माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स। और बट योर कीटोन्स, लाइक इफ आई टॉक अबाउट कीटोन्स, सो द कीटोन कीटोन इज नथिंग बट आर सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ आर, राइट? सो देर इज नो डायरेक्ट हाइड्रोजन एटम ऑन कीटोन, ऑलराइट? सो देयरफॉर योर कीटोन्स आर नॉट ऑक्सीडाइज्ड बाय माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, ओके, फाइन। सो आई जस्ट मेक इट मोर क्लियर। सी वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर HNO3, एसिडिफाइड KMnO4, एसिडिफाइड K2Cr2O7 एक्सेट्रा, एंड द माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, टोलिन्स रिएजेंट, फेलिंग सोल्यूशन। दिस वील बी सीइंग इन दिस चैप्टर अहेड, ओके, आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग इट टू यू ऑल आफ्टर सम टाइम। सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स। नाउ योर एल्डिहाइड्स कैन बी ऑक्सीडाइज्ड इवन बाय माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, ओके, बट योर कीटोन्स कैनॉट बी ऑक्सीडाइज्ड बाय माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स। फॉर दैट यू ऑल नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट, दैट कीटोन्स आर ऑक्सीडाइज्ड ओनली इन विगरस कंडीशन, ओके। नाउ वॉट इज दैट कंडीशन? द फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया इज दैट इट कैन बी ऑक्सीडाइज्ड ओनली विद अ स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, बिकॉज देर इज नो डायरेक्ट हाइड्रोजन एटम अटैच्ड ऑन द कार्बोनिल कार्बन। सेकेंड, देर शुड बी हाई टेम्परेचर, ओके। सो अनलाइक एल्डिहाइड्स विच कैन बी ईजिली ऑक्सीडाइज्ड बाय माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, फॉर कीटोन्स यू ऑल नीड टू सैटिस्फाई दीज कंडीशंस, ओके। सो लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी अंडर लेबोरेटरी टेस्ट, दैट इज टेस्ट गिवन ओनली बाय एल्डिहाइड्स, ओके। द वेरी फर्स्ट वन इज शिफ्ट टेस्ट, ओके। नाउ फॉर दिस शिफ्ट टेस्ट there is no need to remember the chemical reaction or the structure of the reagent, etc. You have to just remember the theory. So what happens over here is, we take alcoholic solution of aldehyde, okay, and in that alcoholic solution we add few drops of Schiff's reagent, okay, fine. Now as soon as I add Schiff's reagent into this, what is going to happen? A pink, red or magenta colored product is formed, alright. This confirms the presence of CHO, that is aldehyde group, okay. So if in a test tube you have a solution and you will have to detect whether it has aldehyde group or not, you can add few drops of Schiff's reagent. If the color changes to any of these, it means that there is aldehyde group present. If not, then it means there is no aldehyde group, okay. The second one is Tollens test or silver mirror test. You all will come to know why it is known as silver mirror test. Tollens test, the Tollens reagent that we are using is nothing but ammonical silver nitrate, okay. The compound is ammonical silver nitrate. Now before I teach you all the main reaction, you all should know what is the structure of Tollens reagent, the ammonical silver nitrate, what is that compound, how it is formed. Now just make a note of one thing, how Tollens reagent is prepared. There's no need to study this particular reaction, okay, it is not given in your textbook. You all have to just study the main reaction which I'll be teaching after this. This is just extra information, okay. So here what is happening, we take silver nitrate. This silver nitrate is dissolved in ammonium hydroxide, okay. So for a certain amount of time, silver oxide is formed as a precipitate. Like in between the reaction, silver oxide is formed as it is precipitated. This silver oxide, it will re-dissolve again in the same ammonium hydroxide. See, we dissolve this silver nitrate in this, we get this for a certain amount of time, and then this precipitate is redissolved in ammonium hydroxide again, and you get this final product, which is nothing but toluene C agent. Now, if you follow all the intermediate steps and balancing, etc., at the end you get two times of this product, but we are not going to go in that detail, okay, because it is not there in your syllabus. So this compound that is formed, it is a complex compound. I am not sure if you all have been introduced to complex compounds or not, but there is a altogether different chapter for it in your 12th standard. Okay, fine. So you all can see there is this much part with a positive charge, and then there is OH minus. So this is the cationic part of the complex, this is the anionic part. So the cationic part which is there, that is the toluene C reagent. Okay, now in complex compounds whenever there's a metal which is bonded with something, so this particular part, it is known as a ligand. Okay, all this will be more clear to you all after you all have studied that chapter. Okay, fine. So your ammonia NH3 is the ligand. So there are two ligands, two ammonia attached on Ag. Okay, fine. Now this ammonia, like individual NH3 has no charge on it. Okay, NH3, it is a neutral ligand. Okay, fine. So where did this plus charge come from? How is this cationic part formed? This plus charge is of your Ag. Okay, fine. This plus charge is of Ag and not of ammonia, because this is neutral. Like there is no charge in it. So this is a neutral ligand attached to Ag, and this plus charge is because of Ag. Okay. So over here, your silver is having plus one oxidation state. All right. Now see students, this toluene reagent is not directly available. Okay, like for you all have to first prepare it. Okay, so whenever you have to react your aldehyde with toluene reagent, there's a note that you all can make that your ammonical silver nitrate is nothing but your toluene reagent is always freshly prepared. So you have to prepare it first, and then only you can react it with aldehyde. That is what happens in real, but in your syllabus, the method of preparing toluene reagent is not mentioned, so there's no need to study it separately. You all just study the reaction where toluene reagent reacts with aldehyde. Okay, so this is the main reaction that we are talking about. See, we have aldehyde, we are adding toluene reagent. I mentioned above that the cationic part of the complex is the toluene reagent. Okay, so we add two times of it in OH minus in presence of a basic medium. Okay, this reaction is happening in presence of a basic medium. This OH minus indicates basic medium. Okay, just at the beginning we saw that aldehyde is oxidized to acid. So now from this aldehyde we are going to get carboxylate ion. Okay, RC double bond O minus, carboxylate ion. Okay, fine. Your silver is precipitated, ammonia is released, and water molecule is formed. Okay, fine. Now this silver metal that is precipitated, it is, you know, like it just sticks on the walls of the test tube in which this reaction is happening. And when you all will like look from above into the test tube, okay, so there you all will like find a slight mirror like structure because of this Ag. And that is the reason it is known as silver mirror test. Okay, fine. So now if you all see over here, our aldehyde is getting oxidized. Okay, our aldehyde is getting oxidized. Okay, and if you all see over here, Ag plus has turned into Ag. Okay, the oxidation state of Ag has reduced, like from plus 1 it became 0. So your Ag is being reduced over here. Okay, so your aldehyde is oxidized and Ag is reduced. Alright, so this is the reaction that is shown by aldehyde. Now this is not balanced yet. Okay, so you have to balance it. So since toluene reagent, there were two molecules, that is the reason in product I'll get 2 Ag, and you all can see this is twice and twice, so 4 times NH3, that is why 4 times NH3 over here. Now apart from this, you all can see here you have 1, 2 oxygen atoms, and on the right hand side there is 1, 2, 3, 3 oxygen atoms, right? So we'll just try to balance it out. So if I put 3 over here, ओके एंड टू टाइम्स ओवर योर, ओके फाइन. नाउ आई हैव फोर ऑक्सीजन आइटम्स ऑन द राइट, आई हैव फोर ऑक्सीजन आइटम्स ऑन द लेफ्ट, ओके फाइन. सिमिलरली आई हैव फोर हाइड्रोजन आइटम्स एंड फोर हाइड्रोजन आइटम्स. सो नाउ दिस इज द फाइनल बैलेंस्ड रिएक्शन. सो दिस ए जी दैट इज प्रेसिपिटेटिंग, इट इज नथिंग बट योर मेटालिक सिल्वर, ओके. इट इज नोन एज सिल्वर मिरर बिकॉज इट इज प्रेसिपिटेटेड इन द टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड इफ यू ऑल विल लुक एट द टेस्ट ट्यूब इट विल काइंड ऑफ लुक लाइक अ मिरर, ओके फाइन. सो आई होप यू ऑल आर क्लियर विद दिस रिएक्शन. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर टोलेंस रिएजेंट, टोलेंस टेस्ट, इट इज शोन बाय बोथ एलिफैटिक एज वेल एज एरोमैटिक अल्डिहाइड्स, ओके. The third reaction is Fehling's test, okay. So in Fehling's test, the Fehling's reagent that we are adding is nothing but, we can call it Fehling's reagent or Fehling's solution. So this Fehling's solution is made up of two components, Fehling's solution A and Fehling's solution B. Fehling's solution A is nothing but aqueous copper sulfate, okay. Its structure is this, CuSO4.5 molecules of water, so aqueous copper sulfate. And Fehling's solution B is sodium potassium tartarate, okay fine. So it is formed from tartaric acid, sodium potassium tartarate, okay. So students, this is the structure of sodium potassium tartarate, okay. See, sodium potassium, here there were H present, like in tartaric acid instead of Na and K there will be H, so that is the structure of tartaric acid. If we replace the H by Na and K, so this is sodium potassium tartarate, alright fine. This is a Fischer projection formula. One more thing, again this is kind of extra information to you all because it is not mentioned in your current textbook, but knowing this would be better from entrance point of view, okay. And you all must be aware that this your copper sulfate solution will be blue in color, okay. So this is the reaction, okay. You all can see your aldehyde, it reacts with Cu2+, which is nothing but cupric ion, okay fine, which is present in our Fehling solution in basic medium, okay, OH-. Same thing, we'll get carboxylate ion because your aldehyde is oxidized, okay. Your aldehyde is oxidized to carboxylate ion and your cupric ion is reduced to cuprous oxide, okay. Your aldehyde is oxidized to carboxylate ion, your cupric ion is reduced to cuprous oxide. Here you all can see the oxidation state is +2 and for in this compound the oxidation state of copper is +1, okay. So you all can see the oxidation state has become less, which means that it has been reduced, okay. I hope you all remember how to extract oxidation state from the compound. This compound overall has no charge, so zero. You have to find for copper, so you will take it 2 times X. For oxygen, it is -2. So the answer of X is 1, okay. So your cuprous oxide has +1 oxidation state. Now this cuprous oxide that is formed, it is precipitated. It forms a red precipitate, okay, fine. Okay, so it is like a red or reddish brown kind of precipitate that is formed. So now we have to balance this, okay fine. So obviously because cuprous Cu2O is formed, so this will become twice, okay. Now the basic medium OH-, we are supposed to take 5 OH- ions, okay. If you all remember the aqueous copper sulfate structure, alright. So there will be 5 OH-. Now let's try to balance the remaining things. On the left hand side, see over here 5O5H, 1H1O. So I have 6 oxygen, 6 hydrogen. On the right hand side, I have 4 oxygens and 2 hydrogen atoms. Okay. So if I make this 3 times, okay, so I'll have now 6 hydrogen atoms and 6 oxygen atoms. Okay. So this is the final balanced reaction. So students, you all can make a note of one point that aromatic aldehydes cannot be oxidized by Fehling solution, okay. We just now studied how the Fehling solution reaction, okay. Now that is only for aliphatic aldehydes, okay. So suppose if you want to differentiate between aliphatic aldehydes and aromatic aldehydes, you can carry out the Fehling solution test because Fehling solution test is positive only for aliphatic aldehyde, okay. For example, your acetaldehyde, so acetaldehyde will form a red brown precipitate, but your benzaldehyde, because it is an aromatic aldehyde, it will not form a reddish brown precipitate, okay. Now students, we saw Schiff's test, Tollens test and Fehling's test, okay. Now your Tollens reagent and Fehling's, both are mild oxidizing agents, okay, but your Tollens reagent is a little more powerful than your Fehling solution, okay. दिस इज बिकॉज योर टोलेंस रिएजेंट कैन ऑक्सीडाइज बोथ एलिफैटिक एज वेल एज एरोमेटिक अल्डिहाइड्स, बट योर फेलिंग सोल्यूशन कैन ऑक्सीडाइज ओनली एलिफैटिक अल्डिहाइड्स एंड नॉट एरोमेटिक अल्डिहाइड्स. ओके ना स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू आर रिमेंबर द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस वीडियो, आई मेंशन दैट कीटोन्स आर ऑक्सीडाइज ओनली इन विगरस कंडीशन. दैट इज कीटोन्स कैनॉट बी ऑक्सीडाइज बाई माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स लाइक टोलेंस, फेलिंग्स एक्सेट्रा. ओके ओके, सो कीटोन्स आर नॉट ऑक्सीडाइज बाय माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स लाइक टोलेंस रिएजेंट एंड फेलिंग सोल्यूशन. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट शिफ्ट टेस्ट, इट इज ओनली फॉर अल्डिहाइड्स. ओके, बट हियर वी हैव वन एक्सेप्शन दैट यू ऑल आर सपोज टू रिमेंबर. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी कीटोन. सो योर अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी कीटोन इज द ओनली कीटोन दैट कैन बी ऑक्सीडाइज यूजिंग अ माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट लाइक टोलेंस रिएजेंट एंड फेलिंग सोल्यूशन. ओके, देर इज अ रिएक्शन फॉर इट, बट आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू ऑल द रिएक्शन, देर इज नो नीड. यू ऑल कैन जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस दैट एन अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सी कीटोन इज एन एक्सेप्शन, इट इज द ओनली कीटोन दैट कैन बी ऑक्सीडाइज बाय अ माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. Just to make things more clear, this is the compound I have drawn here is an alpha hydroxy ketone. Okay, fine. You all can see ketone group C double bond O. Now, this is the carbon on which functional group is attached. So the adjacent carbons are nothing but alpha carbons. Okay, carbons that are adjacent to the carbon which has the main functional group. Now you all can see on this alpha carbon there is a hydroxy group. So this is an example of alpha hydroxy ketone, and this compound is capable of being oxidized by a mild oxidizing agent like Tollens reagent and Fehling solution. So this is an exception. Okay. So students, with this we are done with the A part, tests given by only aldehydes. The next B part and the further properties we will see in the next video. Thank you.